So I had some time to spend with Kim and Sarah individually, and I just kind of wanted to share their hearts with what they shared with me. This was Kim's description of how Sarah loves him. Sarah supports me. She has been the first person to break down all my walls. Sarah loves all of me. Sarah loves my past, my present, and my future. She loves my daughter, Ashlyn, and Sarah's super gentle with her. She knows her spirit. She redirects me when I'm walking the wrong way, taps me upside the head. In fact, Sarah is what I call marriage. So I'm going to chat with Sarah. And this is what Sarah said about Kimmy. Kimmy keeps me grounded, my foundation, my rock. Kimmy knows exactly what I need when I need it. Kimmy's super, super, super patient with me, and she knows how to call me. In fact, Kimmy is my calm. Ashlyn, where are you? Come on up. So this is Kimmy and Sarah's daughter, Ashlyn. Wave to the people. And there is a representation of their family coming together. So some people will do a unity candle. Some people at weddings, you'll see a sand unity. These two have chosen something really special. It's a plant. So I want to tell you a little bit about the basics of a plant. It needs water, it needs soil, it needs nourishment, support, in order for it to grow healthy, and that's what we're going to show today. So this plant is a symbol of their love, and I believe it's Corinthians 13:4-8. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love does not envy or boast. It is not arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in doing wrong, but rejoices in the truth. Step one. Love is an action. Love is a commitment to be intentional about the other. Marriage is about giving up your right to be right because peace is your priority. Like Sarah said, love is a commitment to leave self. Love is a commitment to leave self. It's to let go of ideas so we can build ideas together. Kim and Sarah will now exchange vows.
I intend to make the most of as long as I live. Jim, what an incredible gift it is to watch the light of your heart shine into all the lives that yours touches every day. Your actions, full of love, empathy, and sweet affection, show me there's something better, that I can be better. Your endless capacity to encourage and uplift and bring joy, even into the most challenging circumstances, has helped me to strive to do the same. For all the days and nights to come our way, I promise to fill your life with the same sort of magic you've shown to me, to fill our home with safety and love, to explore this world and navigate life with joy and curiosity, to give you the freedom and space to grow as we take twists and turns, ups and downs of our own. I'll do my best to lead with empathy and deepen my understanding of both of your needs, as long as I physically live. I promise to shine light when your days feel dark, to help you wade the deeper waters of life. I promise to pause and to help push forward as one. I know that neither of us knows what tomorrow holds, but I trust in the one who does. And so for all the nuance, ambiguity, and unknowns that lie ahead, I promise always willing to be the giver of all good things for guidance. It is with immense gratitude and awe that I step forward into this friendship, deeper into our love, and commit fully to you and to us. Yes.
Yeah.
I give you this room. I give you this room as a symbol of my undying love. As a symbol of my undying love, and that I am choosing to share my life's journey with you. That I'm choosing to share my life journey with you. And Ashley, and Ashley, I give you this room. I give you this room with the pledge to love you today. The pledge to love you today. Tomorrow. Married and wifey's. You make your